Studtalk. Welcome to the show. Like green, let's go. Lit team, you know. Straight facts, it flow like season pros. They got that gold rep Toronto. Big up LGBT queens and all in between. Yeah, you're welcome to see. Come along, support the dream. Yeah, assert that dominance. Come with confidence, come with arguments. Ain't no wrong in this, leave the politics. We love all of it, here for all of it. Woo! To each their own, we respect that though. If you got questions, gonna expose. Things ain't always gotta be professional. No, things ain't always gotta be professional. So much more than the stereotypical. Shine some light with some no labels.
Yo, what up, guys? Welcome to another episode of Studtalk. My name is Aprille.
I'm Keish.
And Haeven.
And today, we're gonna talk about committed or uncommitted relationships. Like, we're gonna jump right into it. Guys, talk to me. Are we for it? Are we against it? Like, do we do it?
I'm for committed. You know what I mean?
You already know I'm for commitment too.
Well, duh.
Like, I mean, like, you know, I'm already committed. So to me, like, being in a committed relationship is what I've been doing. So I don't know how it feels to be uncommitted.
Like, okay. Uncommitted as in, like, you're single and doing things, or like, you just wanna. You know what I mean?
What do you mean? Like, so uncommitted, I guess, to me, kind of means when you're like, just you're kind of in a situationship. You know what I mean?
I hate
so you're
situations.
In a relationship. You're in a relationship, you're doing everything, you're going out, you're partying, you're having fun, sleeping together. Okay, cool. But there's just that emotional disconnect.
Yeah, but that's when things get messy, man.
Right.
I already had that.
Right.
That's so I'm not for that.
Yeah.
Like, I don't like those things. I don't like when I have to question things.
Mm.
Like, it's either we're in it or we're not. Unless I tell you, like, okay, we're single and I'm doing my thing,
mm-hmm.
then all right, cool. Mm-hmm. I can do whatever I want. Just don't bug me about it.
Right.
But if it's either going to be committed or we're not.
Right.
Yo.
I'm going to be both in a sense, you know? Like, I feel like for me, it depends on where you are in your life, right?
I know, but what's your preference?
My preference, obviously, committed, like, all day. You know what I mean?
Was that something that, like, happened that you've had growing up? Or was there, like,
it was always
a change?
It was always relationships, but then there was that change where I recognized that, like, everybody's different. Everybody evolves at their own time, right? So there's
That's
a lot
true.
Of times where we'll engage ourselves with somebody and they're not ready to be in a relationship, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, a full-on blown relationship.
Mm-hmm.
But they're still willing to, you know, be around you and hang out and cuddle, right? So for me, like, right now, I'm okay with uncommitted, but straight down, I'd be married.
Yeah, but how does that even work for you? Because my experience with being uncommitted and, like, you know, talking to females or whatever, it always tries to get into something.
Right.
So it's not even like, you could be uncommitted and it's okay with both people. One person always wants something else.
Do you feel like that's because of, like, where we're at right now in society?
I mean, it could be a little bit of both.
Okay.
I think society has, you know, where we're at in society has a lot to do with it too.
Yeah.
You know, what you see on social media and stuff like that. I just feel like when it comes to being uncommitted and if you're messing around with people, for some reason they feel like they still have, like, an ownership on you. So they get kind of sensitive if you do something outside the
right,
box, but
right.
like there's no labels.
Right.
So
right.
that comes down to something that you and that person has to talk about.
Right.
Because like no one likes to talk though.
Exactly.
Well,
that's the
right.
problem.
And that's where it has to start at the jump, right? Like
yeah.
you have to be willing to one, be confident and you're not enough in yourself to be like, okay, this is what I want. This is where I'm at in my life, right? If
yeah.
you find somebody that's on the same page, like a lot of people who are kind of in uncommitted situations are more focused on maybe school or hustling
mm-hmm.
or grinding, right? So
mm-hmm.
for them, a lot of times, and yeah, sometimes, you know, relationships can be distracted in a certain sense, right? So like it balances out, right?
So what about, so we talk about communication because that's
right.
huge in
right.
a relationship. What about those ones that are like, I love you, but I want to like date other people at the same time? So like an open relationship.
Right.
Have you guys been in one? Have you tried it? Are you like
I'm
completely against it?
I'm open to it.
Okay, but why?
But the reason why I'm open to it is because for me, like, it's always been, I don't want to say a dream, but like, it's my thing,
like,
right? To date a woman that is open into bringing other people in the bed.
Okay.
Like, that's just always been my thing, right? Now, would I do it in the sense where like, okay, I have my shorty at home and I'm going to see the next shorty. Like, I don't think I would do it like that, but in the sense where it's open, where, okay, yeah, I'm emotionally committed to you. We're inviting people in our bedroom.
Yeah, so doing it together. Right? That's different.
So together is the key.
Together, I guess. But I don't even know if you'd really call that an open relationship, really, in a sense, right? Like,
well, I mean, kind of.
Right.
I think.
Well, I feel like the term open, at least for me, the term open is more of like, how well have we communicated about this?
Right.
Mm-hmm. You know, like, how honest am I with you about this? Because I feel like open relationships, if you were to bring another woman into the bedroom, mm-hmm. at least you both know what's actually happening.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
But
yeah.
If you're like, babe, I found this girl, I want to da 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 da, I'm letting you know. And you go off and do that, would that be like an okay, would that still be an open relationship? Is that cheating? You know what I mean?
Yeah. I think, again, like, I think it all depends on the person that you're with. A lot of times for people, sex is just sex. You know what I mean? Like, it's just an action. It's just, okay, I got my nut off, whatever, cool, I'm good. Right? But then there's some people that are just like, you know, it's like they're worried about the emotional connection.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how are you making love to them? You know what I mean?
Right. So, okay, so if you are in an open relationship, what rules would you apply to that then? See, to me, I'm not for it. So, like, don't talk to me about that. If you're my girl, you're my girl. There's no open relationship.
Right.
I'm not the type of person to be in an open relationship with my girl.
Right.
I'm not sharing.
Period! 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 Period!
Sorry.
But no, I don't even know it.
There should be rules.
I feel like those are just the rules, though, that, like, that you figure out on the way.
Right.
Because at the same time, it's like, I can go, like, for me being single, I can go and be like, yo, if you want to be in an open relationship, yeah, like, let's do it. But then what if I'm like, down the line, I'm like, nah, I can't do this.
Right.
Right?
The only rule I've been given is just not to give shorty head. She's like, yo, you can strap it up, beat it up, do whatever you want, just don't leave the shorty out. And I can respect that. And I'm kind of the same way too, you know what I mean? Like, I think for me, like, you know, oral sex is something that's kind of like sacred to me. So not everybody
gets that.
Yeah, you know what I mean? No, I get that.
But like,
yeah.
You know, so there's kind of like that, I don't want to say nigga mentality, but like, you know.
Well, y'all already said it, so.
You know, so, yeah, so I don't know. For me, I guess it depends on where you are in your life and, you know, how you deal with that.
Experience is key.
Yeah, no, for real.
Well, hey, we're going to sit on this and hopefully you guys can somehow comment.
Okay, wait, pause.
No, rules and stuff.
I don't sit on anything.
All right. PSA. She doesn't sit on nothing. We're gonna take a break, and I'm gonna take a drink. So we'll be right back.
And I'll admit I don't want another on you, baby. Did I say baby? Yeah, you my babe. So drop the pen you've been drinking, I'll pick you up. Let's cuddle up. Ain't that what's up now? Tell me you been doing anything tonight. I see that you've been with your boys. Stay inside.
All right, guys, welcome back. We're gonna now touch on heteronormative relationships. I didn't say that right. Mm-hmm. Okay, do you feel like in the community we follow that structure?
Absolutely.
Hell yeah.
All right.
Absolutely. I feel like it's really normal though. Like, I know for me, like, it feels normal.
But like, what aspects of a heteronormative relationship do we follow though? That's, cause you're like, yeah, I'm like, yeah, but I don't understand why.
Speaking because I'm more of a masculine female, I need a feminine female.
Okay.
Like,
so you would never date someone similar that like dresses like you or
no. Okay. And that's just not for me. I know there's people out there that do that, but that's just not for me. I prefer a feminine, like a really girly girl.
Word. Like, you know, you're cute, but like, nah.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Like, no, I would never look at him and be like, yo, just take me, like no, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's just not like that. Like, so I don't know, what do you think?
But what about like at home, like in regards to like, you know, being domesticated? Like, for me, like, I'm for it, like, you know, I'll take all the garbage, I'll fix things, I'll wash dishes, cooking. Nah. Not me. That's just
not
me. Nah. Like, quick, easy meals, like mac and cheese, yeah. But you know, our ramen noodles, yeah. But anything else? Nah.
don't know, in my relationship, so I agree. I feel like we do follow a heteronormative mm-hmm. relationship structure. But for me, it's like when I'm dating, I try to do every single thing for my girl. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So cooking included.
Like I do it, but I just feel like that's my shorty's responsibility. Like that's just how I'm
really?
Like, not responsibility. Okay. But like, I prefer to do it. Like I'm just very
guys, like, if you like to cook, hit me.
Okay. On Instagram. But yeah, so yeah, I just
no, I get what you're saying. Like even for me, it's like I'll cook sometimes. I'm not the best cook,
right?
But I'll cook.
Yeah,
I'll help my girl out and stuff like that. But she mostly cooks.
Right, right.
But I don't feel like it's like her thing. You
right,
know what I mean?
Right,
like
right.
Once in a while, I'll surprise her. I'll do a little one too. But
right.
Yeah. So do you guys feel like our roles in our relationships depend on if we're feminine or masculine?
That's a good question.
I mean, I don't know. I like my relationships are like 50-50. It really,
yeah,
you know,
like,
puts in give and take. But
okay, so then what do you feel like for you personally?
Mm.
What have you in your experiences? Like, what have you tended to do more in your relationship? If you're saying 50-50, like,
well, you, like okay, so normally in relationships, like usually I'm the breadwinner. You know what I mean? I'm the one that's bringing the money, taking care of the shorty, and then I don't know. I guess the last few of them have been whatless. But
whoa!
But that's just, in my world, that's just always how it's been. I've always been like the carer, you know, protector, all that stuff. So, I mean, for me, like it'd be cute if my girl like protected me. But I guess there's just certain things in that heterosexual nature that just kind of follows through. Some of the things that I've never questioned in a sense. You know, I've never been like, okay, let me do this or you know.
So have you guys ever been caught off guard by like a more feminine presenting woman like doing things that you would normally do for her?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Like what?
Like to me, when like females are very independent or like very like headstrong, like they know what they want, they know mm-hmm. where they're going, kind of catches you off guard. You know what I mean? Because sometimes, like majority of the time, we come from a role where it's like, oh, we're gonna protect, or we're gonna lead, we're gonna do this,
right.
And it's like, well, nah, I kind of already know what I'm doing, kind of thing.
Right.
So you're kind of like, oh. No,
so,
that's nice.
So I'll give you an example. So I, one morning I woke up with a girl I was dating and she made me breakfast, right? And
mm-hmm.
then she made me lunch to go. And I was like, whoa, this is so cute. But
mm-hmm.
I almost felt like, do you feel like if a woman paid for your dinner,
mm-hmm.
right? Like if your girl paid for your dinner, but you're so used to paying for it, does it take away from like who, how comfortable you feel as yourself as being the bread provider?
No, not at all.
No.
Okay.
I think if the shorty was consistently doing it,
yeah,
always
like,
doing it,
then you're like, yo, this is my role.
Yeah. It's kind of like when they're too independent and you're like, okay, just relax.
Let me help out
with something. Let me get involved.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Why do you find that unattractive? Do you find that unattractive?
If they do everything?
Yeah.
Kind of. It's like, yo, what am I here for then? Like, I want to help out. Like, to me, I like helping my girl out.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? I feel like that's how I show my love too. Right?
Right.
Like, I want to be there for you. I want to help you out. So it's like, if you're doing everything by yourself, it's like, what am I really here for?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So now here's the big question. Sorry, go ahead.
No.
Sex. What about sex? Heteronormative
mm-hmm.
lifestyle for me? Hell yes.
Yeah, definitely. 100%.
Now I'm not going to no buckas.
Not me either. So, are you?
No!
Okay, alright. You gotta make that clear sometimes, you know what I mean?
Bro, I don't even want to
talk about my sex life on here. No, like, I get what you're saying. Like, I'm not gonna be the one that's gonna be submissive like that.
Right.
That's not my role. It actually makes me feel very uncomfortable right now.
Right.
So, hold on a second. So, you don't even want to let your girl win sometimes to make
oh,
her
no,
feel your
way? Oh, no,
listen,
how?
My
girl wins.
Win how?
Cow.
Never mind. My girl has shown me things that I never trusted any girl to do with me.
Yeah.
So, you know, like she has winning brownies right there. But I'm not bending over.
Like, wait, hold on. How did we even get here? Yo,
I'm not bending over. Just letting you guys know.
Okay. All right. Now, the random question here that relates to everything that we've been doing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if there's a feminine female and she presents to you as like more feminine, but acts masculine, is there like, do you guys have an issue with that? Because I feel like that's where we're going with this conversation right now.
Like, you mean like personality wise? Like she's very
anything.
Dominant?
And, anything,
like, the
yeah.
She,
like if she's dominant or like whatever.
Like.
No, I don't have an issue with it.
No.
If she's
if she doesn't look masculine to me, I guess it's not really an issue. To me, it's more about physical than behavior. Like,
okay.
Because I don't want to physically feel like I'm dating someone masculine. So if I don't see that, I guess it's all right. But if she's like, if her personality is really like dominant and like rude, I guess that's okay.
Okay.
Like if she's into like video games as opposed to like makeup, like I'm down. You know what I mean? Like I can deal with that. But somebody that fully represents themselves as me, you know, the way that I represent myself, no.
Okay, so you guys are more so like, she just has to present as a female, like visually.
Right.
I'm getting from you guys.
Right.
Yeah, that's what I'm attracted to though.
Okay, but what I'm gonna like, so recap on the conversation we just had.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
What if she's that dominant in the bedroom, like in life, and but she's like very, very, like she's a femme, and you're like, I want you, but then what if she wants to trap you? Because like she has like a man, like a, I mean,
you bring in the next person, strap her up on
the heart.
No, personally, I
no just stallion.
All right, I think we need to get our bearings in order. Oh my God, that was a lot. I feel like that was a really good, like challenging episode where I feel like we need to continue to pick away at that conversation.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But honestly guys, we're gonna take a break because I'm just like, I'm still trying to get on the stallion comment that here. Yeah, cowboy in it. All right, we're gonna wrap this up. And we'll be right back.
When we started, we was homies. My rolling, and you turn into my baby. My only, it's like anything you do now. It's for me, make me treat you like my trophy. My trophy. Thirsty bitches on my way now. Tell him I ain't got no time for it, no. Gotta go and get my cake now. Ain't talking money, ain't got time for it, no. She fell in love the way I flex it. When we flex and fill it in.
All right, guys, so that wraps things up for this week's episode of Studtalk. We want to know what you think. Like, a lot of things were thrown at us today. Oh, like, comment, subscribe. We want to know your thoughts, but how do you guys feel? Here's your first episode.
Yeah, let us know. I'm just curious to see what everybody else is saying. I just want to know what your opinions are on